Hey folks, welcome back to the channel. It's another day for me going to class at Hogwarts, which is in Wizard Academy. Actually, I think it's my first day of school. We'll find out. If you remember right, in part one, I went ahead and got to school, was pursued and almost eaten by a dragon, and so that was fun. And now I finally got I got sorted, and if I remember right, from all the activity, mind you, I don't quite remember it all because I had such a busy day that first day. I think I'm in House Hufflepuff, but we will see. So let's get started, shall we? Hufflepuff. Okay. Here we go. Okay, I grabbed a bite to eat. Loaded around and nice common room. More bedrooms. I'm gonna just go ahead and peek in everybody's bedroom. Why? Because I'm a nosy person. Don't mind me.
I suppose some introductions are in order.
Yes. Still hungry?
Is that your owl? I don't know whose she is. Likely one of the Hufflepuffs around here. Owls choose their own company anyway. Wait, you're the new fifth year. Quite the dramatic entrance you made. Can't imagine wanting to call attention to yourself, especially since everyone will be watching to see how much you already know. I am a bit concerned. I have a lot of catching up to do. Indeed, 4 years of schoolwork is a bit... being that far behind. I'd feel so... inadequate. Of course, presumably, as a hard-working Hufflepuff, you'll prove yourself in no time. I'm hard-working too, as you might suspect. But sometimes I think I should have been a Ravenclaw. I've rather a searing wit. At least people have always told me so. I'm Lenora, by the way. Lenora Everly. Well, mustn't keep you. You've such a lot to do.
Show off.
Do you really think you should have been in Ravenclaw? Well, my brothers were. They both work in ministry now. I suppose you could say that wit runs in the family. My aunt was a Gryffindor, though, and I've always had plenty in common with her. Determination, valor, daring. The old sorting hat was spoiled for choice with me.
Well, man.
It was nice meeting you, Lenora. Of course. Adieu.
And it was just special. Oh, God, I got to go meet Arthur. Spin the globe.
You don't need to be frightened, little cat.
I can't quite reach.
Come on, you went that way.
Hope they can catch him. Big castle for a student to get lost in, let alone a cat. I'm sure you'll find your way, all right. I mean, it can be a bit overwhelming.
Wow.
I still get lost sometimes. Welcome to Hufflepuff, by the way. Really glad to have you in our house. I'm Arthur.
Thank you. Nice to meet you. Was that your cat?
No, one of the first years, I think. Don't have any pets of my own, unfortunately. My mother doesn't think too highly of them, especially magical ones.
I'm sorry to hear that. I think magical beasts are rather incredible.
Best thing about coming to Hogwarts. Nifflers, Glumbumbles, Bowfruckles. I thought they were only pictures in books before. Well, Dad did bring home a puff skein once. Mum was furious. Anyway, I'd better go make sure the first years caught that cat. Don't want them to be late on their first day.
His voice doesn't match the character model at all. Wow.
Nice meeting you, Arthur. And good luck finding that cat.
Thank you. Try not to get lost in the castle yourself.
Start to a new school.
That's dreadful. Well, I'm glad you made it here alive. Well, anyway, I imagine you have lots to do. I hope you have a wonderful first day.
Are you sure everything is all right with your uncle?
Oh, yes. He travels for work, always busy. I'm sure he just wrote it in a rush. Nothing to worry about.
Thank you, Adelaide. Be seeing you.
Of course. And good luck.
Is the new Hufflepuff out of bed yet? Professor Weasley is waiting for them outside the common room.
Okay, let's go see Professor Weasley.
I trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts.
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs? Owls?
Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success. Here you are.
They all go flying everywhere.
What is it? It is a wizard's field guide. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
Perhaps seeing it in action will answer any questions you may have. Walk with me and we shall put it to the test.
All right.
This way. The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore. I certainly would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Using the guide will also train you to be alert to your surroundings. Do keep up.
For more opportunities.
Okay, so, cool.
Inside and outside of the castle. Opportunity to show you how to use blue flames to get around a bit quicker. Your field guide contains a map of the castle. Open it up and find Central Hall.
Excuse me. Alright. So I went.
And here we are. Quite the time saver. These stairs lead directly to Central Hall. You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall. Always something happening here. It's the heart of the hive. Our King's Cross Station. So to speak. That should be all for now. You'll be expected to attend both Charms and Defense Against the Dark Arts classes today. And I'd like to be sure you get to Hogsmeade as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
Okay. So.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
I'll be polite.
On your first day. And you have much to learn. Happily, your professors have agreed to create additional assignments for you outside of class. You'll be up to speed in no time. Judging by your adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack. My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
So I don't get in trouble.
We did take a bit of a detour on the way here. Ended up exploring some ruins and... I shouldn't say more.
Exploring ruins? Well... I presume Professor Fig has his reasons for keeping the details to himself for now. Speak of the devil, Professor Fig. Your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Well, I'm just glad you both arrived in one piece. Perfectly good boats and carriages to Hogwarts, and you chose to fly in the path of a dragon.
I wouldn't say I chose the dragon's path, Professor. Rather unfortunately, it would seem that it chose us.
Very well. Enough chit-chat. I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you, Professor Fig, to explain the details of the field guide's map?
Of course.
Thank you. Good luck today, and remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you, and invaluable to me, as I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned, and we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmeade for those supplies.
I just didn't. Want to feel like I was lying to the teacher make a bad impression, you know, and all that other stuff. So I guess I'm a teacher's pet. Oh well.
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today, before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you and Professor Weasley talking about exploring ruins?
She caught me off guard. I didn't tell her anything else about our travels here. I will say, I think she suspects we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Yes, well, Professor Weasley is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon.
So I didn't fuck up anything after all.
With your time, then she would approve of. And she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained. Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look. Is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Now, sounds like you've quite a day ahead, what with classes and a trip to Hogsmeade for supplies, including your own wand. You'll enjoy Mr. Ollivander. He's an exceptional craftsman and a good friend. I shall reach out when I have more information about our mysterious locket. For now, focus on your classes and pay attention. More than your owls may hinge on the magic you are able to master within these walls.
The detail in this game is so well done.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Yes. Very cool. like exploring the castle.
Each other to pieces in your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the great poacher raid of 1878. No doubt you've heard of it. Now, you may be asking yourself how an old woman like me single-handedly took out the largest poacher ring in Eastern Wales and lived to boast about it. No. To the wise, age matters very little. Today we will review a spell that has saved me from death at the hands of dark wizards more times than I care to remember. Levioso.
Levioso? A levitation charm?
Levioso. A surprised opponent is a weak opponent. Care to defend yourself, Master Pruitt? No? One thing I've learned as an unspeakable is the value of simplicity. Especially in the heat of battle. Now, let's practice what we've just learned, starting with something small.
All right. Would you look at that? I can move a feather.
You give as good as you get.
I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Hufflepuff.
Thank you, Professor Hecate. Glad to have the opportunity to practice.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it. And they must achieve it. A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can. Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments.
Okay. I will take him on.
That's enough spectacle for one day. Class is dismissed.
Nice work.
I enjoyed that.
Well, that duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? It felt more like I was dueling an expert. Sebastian Sallow, by the way. Didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
In fact, it was. Perhaps I have a knack for it.
Be quiet if you like, but I know better. Magic requires intention and talent. You know, you might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then. Whether it's joining a secret dueling club, or sneaking into the restricted section of the library, you just have to be clever enough not to get caught.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll keep that in mind.
Good. Pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned. We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck.
She thinks he's cute.
Look for Luke and Rattleby near the clock tower entrance. If you're interested.
Oh.
Till next time.
Cassian.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented blue powder. Ravenia.
Okay. It's tea time.
you up to now?
Went the wrong way. Sorry about that. I got distracted. So many stairs.
Is not bad.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just ride on Miss O'Neill here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air. After me.
nice day.
I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree. So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right? Your charm to the last possible moment. Now, think of this like gobstones, if you will, but instead of throwing the marbles out, you are summoning them to hurt you. Splendid! Very good! Very good. Points to Hufflepuff.
Well, yay!
No sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Anai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up. You'll be the blues, just as before, and Miss Anai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
That is so not fair.
Let us make this a bit more interesting, shall we?
Okay.
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
Not exactly your typical lesson, is it? Not that I mind.
Yeah.
did it. You know, when I was playing the game on the Xbox, I kept missing me missing the timing.
I must admit, I think I underestimated you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Akio. Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise. Thank you, but I've been holding my own. I appreciate your confidence. I transferred here from Wagadu just before my fourth year. My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country.
Alright.
This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Wagadu uses one.
You can cast spells without a wand.
Oh, yes. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive. Not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
Is Wagadu much bigger than Hogwarts?
Wagadu School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world. So yes, bigger than Hogwarts. But it never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
Is Wagadu a castle like Hogwarts?
Its address is Mountains of the Moon. It is not so much a castle as a beautiful edifice carved out of the mountainside. I remember the first time I saw it, the mist was so thick I could hardly make out anything at all. And then it just materialized before me, this enormous school that seemed to be floating in midair.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Wagadu, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Of course. You can use Akio on humans.
A word, if you were
so inclined.
Well, you'd be using it on planet.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor.
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? You did well, managing to best as gifted a student as Miss Onai.
Thank you, Professor. I enjoyed the match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late. Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
Been whispering about. Hope your first day's going well. You certainly seem to hold your own in charms.
I've been fortunate. Beginner's luck.
My brother William would tell you not to be so humble and to trust your abilities. Then again,
again, he tends to be overconfident in his.
Well, better see to my charms homework. I'm afraid I can't count on beginner's luck to impress Professor Ronan.
Let me get to Professor Weasley's office. Kitty cat. Oh, cute baby. Got to stop and pet the cats, all of them. It's a mission.
What about the room, Professor?
I was thinking the same thing, Dee. Perhaps you could help me.
Excuse, Deke.
Ah, there you are. I trust your first classes went well?
They did, Professor.
I heard as much from Professors Hecate and Roman. Seems Professor Fig taught you quite a bit during your brief detour near, what was it you said? Some ruins? I'd wager there's a good deal more to your travels here than what you've told me. Isn't there?
Have you and Professor Fig not discussed my training?
He continues to be reticent about the details, mentioning only a few spells. Revelio, was it? And Lumos?
That's correct, Professor.
I see. Like trying to get a sonnet from a stream. Regardless, you must continue to build upon what you've learned. In that regard, I've asked your professors to help hasten your progress with some extra assignments.
Professor Ronan did mention something about that.
In fact, Professor Ronan will meet you outside momentarily to assign your first one. Now, regarding the trip to Hogsmeade I mentioned earlier, we've arranged to replace the supplies lost on your way here, including seeds, potion recipes, and spellcrafts.
Thank you, Professor.
And Mr. Ollivander will connect you with the perfect wand. You've managed your classes well with a borrowed wand, but you'll find the magic you cast with your own wand to be far superior.
To get to Hogsmeade.
Very well. I'd like you to make your first visit to the village with a classmate. Help you get your bearings. Perhaps Sebastian Sallow or Natsai Onai. I've noticed you spending time with them.
I'd like to go with Natty.
Excellent choice. Miss Onai is one of our most talented students. And she knows the area. She'll keep you well clear of any of Victor Rookwood's undesirables en route.
Rookwood?
A rather unsavory local. Best to avoid him and his associates, including his right hand of sorts, Theophilus Harlow, if you can. Once you've finished Professor Ronan's assignment, your friend will meet you at the castle doors. No time to waste. The sooner you complete your work, the sooner you can enjoy a butterbeer at the Three Broomsticks.
Yay! Okay. Okay, so I'm learning repair from the last teacher that I was the last class that I was in. Okay, so I'm gonna do this mission, this last mission, and then get to Hogsmeade and then call it a day for this video, part two. And I'll be back later on to record part three next time. So that's what I'm gonna do. So, here we go.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Ah, there you are.
Okay.
You have a new spell to teach me, Professor?
Indeed I do, and an exceedingly useful one at that. The mending charm, Reparo. Fixes things right up, makes a broken object good as new in the blink of an eye.
It seems as if that might come in handy.
More frequently than one would imagine. As Professor Weasley mentioned, I am not the only one who will be teaching you spells outside of class, in an effort to catch you up with your peers. A number of your professors have agreed to do so as well, but first, each shall ask that you complete a few preliminary tasks to hone your magic. I have arranged some for today. See them through and then report back to me. We will have you casting Reparo in no time.
I'll start on the task right away, Professor.
All right.
Revelio. This is the right area. I wonder where the flying page is.
Sorry about that. have something in my eye.
I'd witness Sebastian lose a jewel.
There we go. And
a flying page must be around here somewhere.
Herself. Wonder she's not gobbled up by her own fanged geranium.
Oh, it's outside.
I trust the preliminary tasks weren't too much trouble.
Assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic. To practice mending something, have a go with a broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover thought it too accurate and lashing.
looking for me?
Natty, I hope I haven't kept you waiting long.
Not at all. Professor Weasley tells me that you need to go to Hogsmeade. You must be eager to have your own things again. And to see the village.
I've been looking forward to it.
Good. Shall we set off? I intend to give you a first-rate Hogsmeade experience. Glad Professor Weasley asked me to accompany you.
Really?
Yes. I had planned to extend an invitation to you myself. I thought you might enjoy a butterbeer in the village. The timing of Professor Weasley's hour was perfect. I cannot tell you how nice it is to breathe fresh air after being cooped up in ancient rooms. Grave mistake to take it as an elective class, believe me.
I believe you.
Though I suppose you would not really call it elective when your mother was the one who elected that you take it. Hogsmeade is beautiful this time of year. Everyone will tell you to visit at Christmas, but that's one of the few times of year I would rather be indoors.
Not much for the cold, are you?
Oh, I do not mind the cold so much, but it has taken some getting used to. I did not grow up around snow. Oh, wait, over here. I often spot lacewing flies in this area.
Oh, what's so special about them?
They are interesting to look at, but if you stew them, you can also use them in potion making.
There.
Professor Weasley mentioned that you knew the area, since you're relatively new here.
She said that? She knows more about me than I have thought. I will say, while I certainly learn a great deal in class, much can be gleaned outside of the castle walls. Settling in. I remember the weeks that followed my arrival feeling quite strange. Everything was so new and unfamiliar.
I'm getting used to things. What about you? Do you finally feel settled?
I still miss my homeland, but it is beautiful here too. And getting out of the castle and exploring helped me to adjust quite a bit. Hogwarts has become something of a home now, I would say. Hopefully it will for you too. He is the Hogwarts caretaker. Looks a bit worse for wear. Hello, Mr. Moon. Have you met our new figure?
Pleasure. You might want to turn back, Miss Onai. Turn and run.
Is everything all right, sir?
Oh, he looked right at me. Eyes big as saucers.
What did Mr. Moon?
Jelly guys. Ugly and airy and terrifying. I shall be at the castle where it's safe. Good luck to both of you.
Poor Mr. Moon. A demigod. I think he had too much fun in the village. I will say that I have never seen him in such a state. Nearly there. There is much to see outside of the castle walls, not just Hogsmeade. I am happy to explore whenever you'd like. Rumors being what they are about goblins and such, it might be nice to have a friend with you.
I'll keep that in mind, Natty. Thank you.
And here we are. It is hard to know where to start. The Three Broomsticks is the place for butterbeer. And you can get any sweet you can imagine at Honeydew's. I could not choose a favorite shop here. It changes with every visit. I can tell you that you are certain to find everything you need in Hogsmeade. Professor Weasley said that you need to get potion recipes, spellcrafts, some seeds, and...
anyone.
Of course! You will enjoy Mr. Ollivander, and I am keen to see what you will do with a wand of your own. You should be able to collect everything you need and still have time to explore a little as well. Experience Hogsmeade at your own pace. We can meet up in the town circle when you are finished. Enjoy yourself. I will see you soon.
Here we go. I'm gonna call it here for the night. This is the end of part two. I will be back later to do part three. Thank you so much for clicking on the video and watching. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you want to. Until next time, I will see everybody when I do the next video. Hope you have a great day. Bye for now.